It seems the UK could be heading for a softer Brexit, and we've had a lot of talk this week about the option of a customs union. So what exactly is that? Well, a customs union would mean an easier flow of goods between the UK and the EU, so paying no customs duties between the two and inside Europe, and applying the same external tariffs to goods coming from the rest of the world. So that would cut out a lot of the need for time-consuming, expensive paperwork, although not all of it. And at the moment, the EU's major existing customs union with Turkey doesn't cover agriculture, so it wouldn't sort out the situation at the border between Northern Ireland and Ireland. To do that, Northern Ireland would need to comply with EU single market rules. So that basically brings you back to the same situation as the infamous backstop, but permanently. Another hugely controversial point: being in a customs union would severely limit the UK's ability to strike independent trade deals with countries around the world post-Brexit. And that was a promise of the ruling Conservative Party when they won election back in 2017. And on the bright side, the UK would continue to benefit from the current 69 trade deals negotiated with the rest of the world by the EU and any it strikes in future. And on a global scale, the EU is more of a heavyweight than the UK, home to 500 million people as opposed to the UK's 66 million. There are other complexities too, such as transport permits for British lorries travelling across Europe, for example. At the moment, the EU has only granted those to countries inside its single market, such as Norway or Switzerland, so that would have to be negotiated too. But overall, a customs union is a solution that the EU already knows and so could apply quite quickly. Unfortunately, it's absolutely hated as a solution by hard Brexiters in the UK, so the political turmoil doesn't look like it's quite over yet. And that's it for this time on Brex-what. Do join us again next time.